I have proof that proof doesn't exist. Satanists are not devil worshippers. So what's the beauty in faith? I kept talking about the beauty in faith. You don't see the beauty in faith. It's like you meet some guy and he has a wife who you think is really ugly and he says, "Don't you think my wife is beautiful?" You say, "What's the beauty in your wife? Look at her, she's ugly. There's nothing there." This guy sees the beauty. Let him see his beauty. It's that simple. That's the beauty of faith. You see it, they don't. They see it, you don't. Tangible. About being a realist, we talk about things you can prove with your senses. Our ability to prove and disprove things has changed over time. There was a time that we thought the world was flat, and it wasn't that long ago, and we were convinced. And you were a fool if you thought something else. So the truth will keep changing. The truth never changes. Our perception of the truth will change. So you base your realism on what you think is tangible and real, and then as new evidence comes up, you change your view. And someone said that that may be actually what atheism is, that they're waiting for the proof. If you think that believing all these religious stories is ridiculous, they think that believing your disbelief is ridiculous. Why don't you both just show each other respect, providing that one of you doesn't squash the other? Like a lot of people say, look how religions treat gays. I mean, what a great opportunity for Muslims, Christians, Jews, everybody to get together and bash the gays together. It could be a common bond of hatred. That's sad. A lot of people are born gay. I think there's a whole spectrum. And to punish people for the way they were born seems very sad to me. Say, well, it says right here in the Bible, being gay is a sin. If that's true, love the sinner, hate the sin. That's the best you can do. I think showing love and showing compassion, showing restraint is a great gift on all sides. There's no place for arrogance. There's no place for abuse. It doesn't serve anybody. Even if you think their story is ridiculous. Faith looks ridiculous on a balance sheet. But people feel it. It's just as true to them as a radio wave or love. Or, you know, a lot of those are funny. They're sort of ethereal. But it really doesn't matter to me. What matters to me is that we love each other the best we can. Why can't I question religion? Sure, question all you want. Say you disagree. Just don't be cruel. Calling Hitler an atheist is a bad idea. They said Stalin would have been a better pick, and maybe that's true, but the stuff I read about the horrible things Hitler said about Christians when he was professing to be a Christian, they were ruining the planet, all these sort of things, you know, and then a bunch of people said they were atheists, that Hitler was an atheist, then I went and checked on other sites and said that's not true, but it doesn't matter. Why would Hitler being an atheist have any negative reflection on atheists? Stalin was an atheist. Pol Pot was an atheist. All these millions of people died at the hands of atheists. There's no such thing. It's like saying millions of people died at the hands of Muslims. They're not Muslims. It wasn't atheists. It's people. And someone criticized me and said, look, you look at this crazy circular logic. You say you can't blame religion because religion's a scapegoat. You can't blame the people because the people are scapegoats. And it looks like I'm double talking. You're getting ready to do something bad. So you do the rallying cry of God and get religion on your side. So religion takes a hit and looks bad. Now all the religious people look like bad guys too when they haven't done anything. But there is this core of religious people that are doing bad things. That's bad. They're bad guys. They're behaving badly. Those are the ones. I agree. Nail them to the wall. Punish them. They're doing bad things. But let's not paint with such a broad brush that we end up painting over innocent people. You start blaming atheists and blaming Muslims. You know, if you want to blame a Muslim that's out there abusing women, abusing gays, killing innocent people, I'm with you. I don't like what they're doing. I think it's wrong. I think they should stop. I think it's offensive. But it shouldn't paint all Muslims badly. You know, the Christian who's going to the funeral saying God hates gays and our acceptance of homosexuality is the reason why American soldiers are dying in the Middle East and all just goofy stuff like that, you know, they're wrong. It's dangerous. The people who are using religion as a tool to stomp on people, it's wrong. But we should never make the next step. and we should never say anything bad about any groups, unless everybody in that group is an undeniable, dangerous, deadly asshole. Then we can say it. And I don't know a single group that is completely filled with undeniable, dangerous assholes. Unless it's a really small group of undeniable, dangerous assholes. I got some incredible insight about who is to blame for all the problems in the world. Some say it's the Christians, others say it's the Muslims. Some say it's the atheists. Some say, well, there's a whole list. And I have the answer. I met some lovely ladies who happened to be, I hope these are little bunnies, they're quotations, lesbians. And these lesbians have informed me, very nice ladies, that the problems with the world have to do not with religion and not with the lack of religion. It has to do with men. And men are the problem, because you look at almost all the killing, it is done by men. And then I started thinking further, that maybe it isn't men that are the problem. Maybe it's grown-ups. Maybe grown-ups are bad. Or it could even be humanity. Now imagine if we were able to just sort of blame humanity for everything. That would make it simple. Except for, we are humanity. Well, that's a little tricky. But the lesbians had an interesting point, that men are bad. And I think I should maybe be a little ashamed. How would a shame feel? Yeah, that might serve me well, along with my guilt and my gout.
Play on, America!